Good afternoon, volleyball fans from high above courtside at Worcester State University. It's the Division II Girls State Volleyball Finals. For the second year in a row, your undefeated Westborough Rangers find themselves one win away from the state title. This time, it's all about finishing the job.
Coach Anderson's the best, like he really is. He's also a teacher at Westborough, so you can always go to him whenever you need anything. He's really caring and really truly cares about what you think and feel.
My goal now is to try to give each player what they need and each team what they need. And you know, you try to figure out during the season what works and what doesn't. You know, come out of a timeout and they're terrible and you go, well, I'm not gonna say that again. But I think this group really bought into, you know, the things that we believe in.
Prior to the 2022 season, Coach Roger Anderson had been at the helm of WHS volleyball for 22 years. During his time, he developed a reputation as a beloved member of the WHS community and coach in the eyes of his players. Along the way, he managed to forge a perennially winning program, capturing 14 league championships and 2 state titles. This year, however, would prove to be one of the most successful ones of his storied career.
Heartbreaking defeat in the state finals, a perfect regular season, losing only 2 sets all year in 2021, marked one of the more historic runs in Massachusetts volleyball. Though once again in the forefront, WHS volleyball finds themselves in a near identical situation, holding a record of 11-0 in mid-October.
Seemingly identical to last year, you guys finished the regular season power rankings at number 1, lined up for home games until the state finals here in this gym. Big external expectations to finish the job this year. What was your thought process before each of the playoff games?
Even if I'm struggling, my teammates have my back. And like we all were going to do it together. And we had all learned a lot from last year's loss. And so we knew that like we weren't going to let that happen again.
So I think we went into the playoffs knowing that we couldn't take anybody lightly. You know, even when we're playing the 32 seed, we cannot take that game lightly at all because they're there for a reason.
Let's take it back to over a month ago. On October 12th, I came into this very gym and asked you, what are your expectations going into playoffs? You gave the humble answer of, we're just going to continue to try and get better and work harder. Sitting here a month later, obviously, things have transpired since. What was the thought, or was the thought in the back of your mind the whole season of making it back to the state championship?
No, the thought was to win.
You can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Go tell that long-tongued liar, go and tell that midnight rider, tell the rambler, the gambler, the backbiter, tell him the gods go.
I think as the playoffs went on, we got better. The fact that it was playoffs and as the rounds, like, oh, like another team got knocked out, another team, like, oh, I have a club teammate on this team that, like, they're done. I think that kind of set in for us and was like, wait, our season could end. Like, we got to step up our game.
I will go tell that long-tongued liar, go and tell that midnight rider, tell the rambler, the gambler, the backbiter, tell him the God's gone. God's gonna cut him down.
And the Rangers will now be on the road to play in the Final Four, site to be determined. It'll be Tuesday, November 15th, against Dartmouth.
But after the game, I just like broke down into tears. Like, I didn't cry on senior night because I knew we'd have other games at home. It was that last home game that really got me.
I think definitely we felt some pressure. We knew Dartmouth was a good team and we played them earlier in the season. But I mean, every team gets better throughout the season and we hadn't played them in a while. So we definitely felt a little bit of pressure, but we also like were trusting ourselves. Like, we have been playing all season long. We know each other really well. We're really talented. And so we just made sure that they were believing in what we knew and what we had already done, and we were going to get it done.
Get through Dartmouth, now one win away from the state title, but this is the same position that you guys were in last year, a 3-0 convincing state semifinals win, undefeated season, everything seemingly going perfect. Nearly 1 year to the day. It was 1 year off. That was crazy. I was looking at that.
Yeah.
Did the memory of last year still linger in your mind before heading off to Worcester State?
Oh, absolutely. But the night before, we were watching the D3 state final in the gym, and last year we watched the D5 state final in the gym. And I talked to Coach. I was like, Coach, something feels different about this year. I don't know what it is, and I don't know if it's good or bad, but something feels different. And he's like, I think it's a good different.
And just going with our regular routine, because we went with the mindset of it's just a game, so that we could really just stay focused on one point at a time.
And then really, we tried to use language that was appropriate, and our language in the state finals was until the job is done.
But the job wasn't done yet. In just a few hours, they would square off against the number 2 ranked team in the state, enter a packed gym with expectations higher than the 50-foot ceilings, and for many of them, play their last high school volleyball game. But succumbing to these pressures is not what the 2022 WHS girls were all about. Rather, they were a banded bunch, bounded by the failures of a year prior, the struggle of maintaining an undefeated season, and the countless years worth of friendships forged by their commitment to a greater goal. But today it all came to a head, win or lose. They had the greater goal in the palms of their hands yet again. As Coach Anderson said, it was now time to finish the job.
Thank you.
The ability to make a statement in that first set really seemed to be a theme all year for you guys. Did it calm the nerves after you had that first set won going into the second set?
Personally, it's the second set for me that, like, if we get two sets under our belt, I'm feeling good. But yeah, I think the first set, it's kind of like a deep breath for us. But we also know, like, all right, they lost the first set. They're going to, like, throw everything they have at us.
Right.
So we were definitely prepared for that.
One set away. To this point, this is further than you made it last year. What was the thought process going into that final set and in the last few points?
Well, the last game was really close. So it was kind of just like, okay, we gotta go. Like, let's keep it to three. Let's not make it four. But at the back of my mind, I was like, well, if it goes four, it's okay. Cause like, we'll come back.
Right.
And I said this to one reporter. I was like, it took me a few minutes to process it. And then once I did, I was just like overwhelmed with emotion.
I said the same thing. Another quote we used a lot, and it didn't matter whether we were behind or ahead, was, we're right where we want to be. And that had nothing to do with the score. It was about feeling the connection between the players and being right where we want to be. And I literally said to them, you know, you guys, I don't know very many quotes, but one I've said before is, we're right where we want to be. And then they went out and you know, our opponent played it a little bit safe, and we didn't.